there.
It was my second day at Mirissa out of the 12 unforgettable days I spent in Sri Lanka. And it was indeed a very special day for me as I set out to catch a glimpse of the largest mammal in this planet. So if you are going on this whale watching trip, I would suggest you be up and ready as early as possible in the morning, as an assigned tuk-tuk driver will come to your doorstep to pick you up. So from my Airbnb where I was staying, it took me around 15 minutes to reach the port from where all the launches set off for whale watching trips. One tip I would have for all of you watching this video is that try and arrive at the dock as early as possible, because when I reached there I was personally a bit disappointed when I saw so many people on one boat, and moreover, if all the seats at the side and in the front are occupied, the view might not be the best. However, I decided to go right at the front and have a seat by the railing as the trip went on. Before the trip begins, the tour guides give a certain medical pill for those who might face problems from seasickness. Please do not take this request lightly, or you just might end up ruining your day. Normally, the sea is calm during the months of November to April, but the tour operators prefer conducting whale watching trips during the rainy season, although the sea is very rough during that time. The main reason being, planktons start growing near the shore and hence the whales are very close and is easier to find. On the other hand, if the sea remains calm, the boats have to go further into the ocean to spot the whales. It was told to us by the tour guides that the boats prefer going to the same location where the whales were found the previous day, since studies show that whales have a tendency to stay at one place for around 2 to 3 days. And since those were residential whales, there was 98% chance of spotting a mammoth blue whale. The biggest blue whale which has been spotted in Sri Lanka till now is 34 meters wide.
Till now we have not spotted any whales so far, but guards here are saying that they have got some information regarding whales, and it's somewhere up in front. Some of the fishermen boats over there has actually informed that. So let's see if we can get to see one.
So we were almost an hour into the Indian Ocean, and the strong breeze over the ocean felt really good and refreshing. However, there were still no signs of any whales. Under these circumstances, all the boats communicate with each other and other local fishermen around for any possible information on the coordinates of the whales.
I think we are approaching the location because as you can see there are some other boats there as well.
Finally, after 1.5 hours of moving into the Indian Ocean and after travelling 15 nautical miles, the tour operators found a signal on the possible coordinates of the whales. All the people in the boat rushed towards the front end and the side railings. So most of us sitting in front were able to see the blowhole, but the entire whale was never visible and it was pretty far away. In general, during whale watching tours, mostly the tail or the blowhole of the whale is visible. The entire whale is never visible until you are lucky enough to see the whale jump out of the ocean. But by now, the real fun had begun. Every now and then the boats would receive some signals of the possible coordinates of the whale since they were nearby, and they would move at full speed trying to approach the whales. The only thing that I disliked in the entire tour was the probable violation of the sea mammals observation control regulations. The coastal guards were absent on that day, which is why some of the boats took an undue advantage by moving towards the whales too fast and probably going too near them and frightening it away. After some more of hide and seek, finally I was able to witness the giant blue whale, not once, not twice, but four times, and it was a moment to cherish. So now sit back and enjoy. On our return journey from the location, we saw some dolphins and the very rare fly fish all over the place. It was indeed an experience worth remembering. And in case you are visiting Sri Lanka and missing out on this whale watching activity at Mirissa, you are going to miss a great deal.